Not far from the walls of Inna, there is a deep pool. Burgess is its name. Caister does not hear more songs than rise from the swans on its gliding waves. A wood encircles the water, surrounds them on every side, and its leaves act as a wheel, dispelling Phoebus shafts. The branches give it coolness and the moist soil. Tyrine, purple flowers there. It is everlasting spring. While Proserpine was playing in this glade and gathering violets or radiant lilies, while with girlish fondness she filled the folds of her gown and her basket, trying to outdo her companions in her picking, dies almost in a moment saw her, prized her, took her. So swift as this its love, the frightened goddess cries out to her mother, to her friends, most of all to her mother, with piteous mouth. Since she had torn her dress at the opening, the flowers she had collected fell from her loosened tunic, and even the scattering caused her virgin tears. The ravisher whipped up his chariot and urged on the horses, calling them by name, shaking out the shadowy dark tight reins over their necks and manes. Through deep pools, they say, and the sulphurous reeking swamps of the Pelasai vented from a crevice of the earth to Syracuse, where the Bacchinadi, a people born at Corinth between two seas, laid out their city between unequal harbors.